Hi, I'm Derek Young. I'm your County Council representative for District 7. I'm halfway through my four-year term, and I'd like to talk with you a little bit about what we've been able to accomplish over the last couple years and what the future holds. My district represents Gig Harbor, the Key Peninsula, Fox, Raft, and Heron Islands, as well as Tacoma and Ruston. What this diverse district has in common is shorelines. A big focus in 2015 and 16 was a long overdue update to the county shoreline master plan. The plan had not changed since the 70s, and the state required a number of changes, so we had a lot of work to do. As sponsor, I made sure that we balanced habitat protection with property rights. Aquaculture, particularly goey duck farms, are concerning to our citizens. Unfortunately, the state's response makes clear that they want us to strip out many of these protections, but I'm ready to fight to protect our community and Puget Sound. Many of the communities I serve are growing quickly, and that's expected to continue over the next 20 years, especially in cities like Gig Harbor. To help us guide and manage this growth, the council passed a 10-year update to Pierce County's comprehensive plan. The plan is designed to protect rural habitat and working lands while building strong, sustainable communities.
Councilmember Young.
Aye.
In November of 2016, the council passed a bill I sponsored to dramatically increase the construction impact fee for parks. This allows Pierce County to collect a one-time fee from developers for every new home or apartment that's built in unincorporated Pierce County. That way, growth helps pay for its impacts on the services we provide. What that means for you is the county will have the money to buy and develop new parkland with amenities like trails, playgrounds, and athletic fields. Years ago, the county bought the Devil's Head property at the tip of the Key Peninsula, but it's not a park people can safely access. My hope is that the park impact fee funds, along with other funds I've been able to direct in the budget, will change that.
The distribution of the parks is pretty well spread out, even in the timing of when they're going to happen. So you see a timeline that goes from near term to long term that will make sure that we're making investments all over the county.
Your safety is very important. And I'm excited that our 2017 budget adds a new community liaison deputy to the Sheriff's Peninsula Detachment. The position will focus on more proactive policing, which is critical to reducing crime on the peninsulas, while not pulling deputies away from responding to emergencies. You also should know that the County Council created a property crimes unit in 2015 to proactively go after the small number of criminals who commit the majority of property crimes. This unit is already having a lot of success. Looking ahead 5 to 10 years, giving the Fox Island Bridge a new lease on life won't come cheap, but I've begun planning for that now. The price tag for the major repairs is great, but replacing the whole bridge is even greater. Either way, we're going to need multiple funding sources to get the job done. We will continue to have community meetings throughout this development process, like we did this past August, to get more feedback on bridge options.
It exceeds our total road budget by several orders of magnitude. This would be a major, major project. So it's important that we not only start thinking about what we want the replacement or rehabilitation to look like, but then start building a funding strategy. And that will take some time in and of itself before we can even get to the design phase.
Responding to the behavioral health crisis in our county remains a challenging task. That's why I sponsored a study last year to better understand the scale of the problem and an ordinance this year to respond to it. The ordinance, if passed, would have Pierce County join the City of Tacoma and 22 other counties in adoption of the 0.1% sales tax for behavioral health. I developed a policy framework for the tax that demands careful planning, accountability, and performance measurements. I'm heartbroken to tell you that we were unable to pass the tax. The council voted 4-3 in favor of the ordinance, but failed to reach the supermajority required by the county charter. Despite months of work and overwhelming community support, not to mention the obvious need for suffering families, we were unable to reach an agreement. This isn't over. The need won't go away. I won't stop fighting until the council steps up and accepts this responsibility.
And I'm so happy to be here at the Harbor History Museum to share a snapshot of the important issues and legislation I'm working on. As always, I appreciate all your support and comments throughout the year. Please never hesitate to contact me if you have any questions or concerns. Thank you.